Hi guys, Jacob here from the Yorkshire Canine Academy. So we've just had Bear dropped off to us. Bear is a male, 18-month-old German Shepherd, cross Akita, and he's suffering from some lead reactivity, some frustration-based reactivity on the lead. So our task for the next 5 days is kind of to help Bear understand the basics of what a lead really means, increase the handler's value. We're gonna load a marker, and we might use a clicker to do that. Give him an appropriate outlet for this kind of prey drive, chase drive that he may have, so that'll be through the means of play, and just give him quite a lot of structure and clarity going forward. We don't want to add in too much structure to begin with. We want to make pals. I might sit down, give him a couple of treats, have a little play with him, let him find his feet, and then we're going to start kind of lead fundamentals and things like this. I lost my mind. My heart's been stolen. The purpose of this activity is to show Bear where there is going to be value found and where there's not. So we do this for about 5-10 minutes in a completely sterile environment. We don't want any distractions in just yet. We want Bear to have a very good understanding of how to turn off pressure and where to find reinforcement before we add in the distraction. If you notice, when Eloise is marking, she's marking with yes. The yes comes before the delivery of food. We want to keep the food out of sight for Bear so he doesn't anticipate or make a cost-benefit analysis of the treat that may be placed in front of his nose. So we're not luring at this stage, we're just marking and rewarding behavior. And that behavior we're marking and rewarding is typically him paying us attention. So we're on day two with Bear, and today is going to be his first play session. Got him on a long line for play just in case I cannot control the environment. For example, there's a dog over there now, and you can see Bear is fixating on that dog, right? Me having the long line on him can stop him running away, finding value in playing with other dogs, and then making the issue that we're working through even worse than it already is. So, just finishing up the day with Bear now. He goes home this afternoon. What we've concentrated on for his residential stay is building his motivation for toys and food. So his owner goes home with things to work with when we're teaching him obedience and managing, controlling, changing, modifying his behavior. The second thing we've done is taught him a very clear-cut set of rules of while he's on the lead. Bear's done exceptionally well. He's not had an adverse reaction since kind of day three here. He joined in a group class today and did exceptionally well. So we look forward to handing him back over to his owner, going through a couple of rules and changes that we need to make at home, ready in preparation for session two. His owner is going to join us next week for session two and hopefully join us on a group class. Account. The way we empty that bank account is by putting money in the alternate bank account, which is not barking at dogs. We have just put, over the last 5 days, a lot of money in the bank account of not barking at dogs. The worst thing you could start doing is taking him and start letting him put money, make deposits back in the old bank account. guiding to my left is Sneaky. Good lad. Would you like to give that a go for me, mate? Him on your left. Anytime his collar passes your toes, you're going to take your right hand turn.